The first thing I always recommend with, like, if you are doing VMs on Azure is, like, figure out if you really need to, like, what's the size, what do you actually need. I think we are offering almost 300 different sizes and types of VMs, right? And those are, like, optimized for different scenarios. So some of them are optimized for, like, small workloads, some of them for CPU-intensive workloads. We have some memory-intensive workloads. We have some with graphics adapters, some with ultra-fast storage. And, like, so you need to figure out what is actually the size I need. And what I realize is a lot of people also who migrate VMs to Azure, they just take the size they used on-prem like they had before. And turns out that a ton of these VMs were just oversized, right? You have probably seen that before. Like, okay, I have a domain controller or a web server here. I just give it like 16 gigs of memory because we have it anyway, right? In Azure, you pay for this, or in every cloud, you start paying for what you're actually using. So if you can, like, do the, like, create a smaller size of that VM, that's really helpful. And so people may ask now, Thomas, why? How can I actually find out that my VM is too, like, size too large, my on-prem VM, for example, before I move it to Azure? And turns out that Azure Migrate, which is a product which we have, or a service, if you will, which helps you migrating VMs, but also databases and other workloads as well, can go out and measures your on-prem environment and does an assessment of it. And it can go and do performance analytics over time. So it can tell you, hey, okay, that VM has 4 cores, but actually you only need 2 cores. It's not that the VM ever needs that much resources, right? So now I see you are, I think, on the Azure Migrate page. That's exactly the great thing to use. Even though if you're not migrating, and again, this is free, right? You can add some third party and they will cost some additional money because they have additional capabilities. But you can do a free assessment of your environment without moving anything, like just to see, hey, how I'm actually sized on-prem. And then you can take that knowledge and basically start migrating or creating the VMs as you want it. And that's only when you have on-prem VMs which you want to move to cloud. And then, sorry that I jumped there, but I have to mention that as well. If you already have VMs in Azure, we have something fantastic called the Azure Advisor, which can go out and, hey, like, does the same thing and tells you, hey, this VM might be not sized the right way, right? There's a lot of different recommendations, but it can also do recommendations on sizes. So as you said, picking the right size is the first thing which you should do right? You should not just select something because you think that matches. You should really understand what to pick, because that will give you a much more cost-effective solution.
Yeah, exactly. And it's funny is that I had a couple of people in one of my sessions, and I was talking about, well, I was mentioning some of the free stuff, and they were like, oh, no, you can't host an app service without paying money. And like, actually, well, no, you know, that's free as well. And what was kind of happening there was that because we want, you know, you to have, like, you know, high availability, and we expect a lot of people that's, like, using app service or other ones, you know, it may be a company website, it may be even more. And so we kind of, you know, guide you into a place to where, like, custom domains and some of the other stuff is, like, available for you. But there's also the free SKU that I hardly ever hear anybody, like, really talking about. And I use the free SKU for all kinds of little personal, like, little projects. And it is a shared instance, but yep, it does give you a ton of information about how to kind of get up and get started and start building, you know, with Azure. Yeah.
Absolutely. I cannot stress this enough. A lot of people don't know about this free offer. Really, you should have a look at that and, like, to get started and run. You can run a couple of different things. If you have a small project, you can do that. I think, to coming back, like, you're in this Azure Advisor thing, what the question also was about is, like, that shutdown and turning off and running it in a way. And the next thing, really, if you pick that sizes, it's also about picking the right model, right? So of course, the cloud is great if you have that like agility and elastic, like you can basically go and size it the different ways and you can shut it down and you save money. So that's also a recommendation, obviously, as mentioned in the question, that you shut down your VM because then you only pay for storage. However, and that was also in the question, is that a lot of workloads do not really work that way, right? I mean, I cannot just shut off like basic services which need to run 24/7. But for these VMs, we have something which, like, for strangely, not a lot of people know about, and it's called reserved instances. So if you know that you have a VM which basically runs 24/7 for a year or even 3 years, you can do basically a pre-commit for that, or you can basically commit to have that VM running for a year, and you pay, and you say, okay, and you get a highly reduced cost for that, right? So yeah, you pulled up the website that here you can see that. And the great thing is now, I think we did that change a couple of months back, is that like before you had to pay that upfront. So you had like, okay, I know I'm gonna run this VM for 3 years. So you get a highly discounted VM, but you needed to pay that upfront. And now we changed it. Now you can pay that, like you get still get the discount, but you don't have, you can pay that cost over time, like in a monthly fee, basically to like not pay just everything up front, right? Which makes a lot of customers very happy. I think that is like where I say where companies who run a lot of VMs, either you run them like 24/7 or you run them like for a moment and then shut them down. So those are like two main differences depending on the workload you run in that VM.
Yeah, exactly. And Gregor made a great comment about it being monthly as well now too. Just pulling that out monthly. Some cloud providers allow you to right size VM simply based on RAM cores, etc. You can set it to 4 cores and scale the RAM without limits. Azure uses preset fixed RAM combos. Why wouldn't Azure allow custom core RAM ratios? I've never actually tried to do anything like that before. Have you?
Well, I remember like when I did run for some companies, when I rerun like their virtual machines on-prem, right? We could really go out and fine tune everything into the last configuration, right? I think the problem we have with that, and I believe that we, again, with those, like, I think it's currently 300, it could be even more, different sizes. We really try to make it like as good as like possible for you to pick the right size, right? There should be a size for every of your workflow. Yes, maybe sometimes we don't have exactly what you wanted, but this is also a little bit of to do with how we do capacity management in the backend, right? Yeah. You like imagine if everyone would just like deploy VMs with 1 core and like 2 terabytes of memory, right? And we would not be prepared for like, in that case, maybe not have the right hardware sizing. So what we did is actually we have different hardware types, and then we map different VM sizes to it so that we always have enough capacity for all these different cases. And I absolutely agree. I really hope, like if it would be interesting to know what VM size and what scenario you are missing. That would be very interesting to know, so we can have a look at that.
Yeah, and also there is 290 of VM. Yeah, there is 290. One of the other things I was going to mention here was that I picked the Windows 10 Pro, you know, just, you know, we have like a bunch of other kind of Windows machines I use and just a virtual machine. As like you're looking like through this, you know, I think this is filtered to, well, this is filtered to the current like standard size. But there is quite a bit of things to pick from. But then I noticed that down here at the bottom was this pricing calculator. So there is a pricing calculator that kind of like comes with that. But yeah, it would be interesting to know what exact scenario isn't available in this sort of an option.
Yeah. By the way, this is interesting what you just have open there. You see the VM sizes, which start like with a B. This is also probably something to think about what we have here. I always think a little bit about two scenarios there. One is the burstable VMs, as you can just see here, which basically allows you to like say, hey, your VMs usually don't like really utilize the CPU that much, but at one point they need it, right? So we basically give you like you get a cheaper VM because you don't utilizing the CPU that much. And but then you can burst it out, and when you need it, when your VM needs it, they can get a better, can get more performance in that time. So you can also look at solutions like this, where we have like different machine types. What I also should mention is the new offering we have with Spot Virtual Machines. So think about where you have a really large task which you need to do some calculations on, and you need a lot of different VMs and resources basically to calculate this. And you don't care if a VM dies at one point and you just add more and more because the calculation just goes forever. So Spot VMs are a really great solution for that. So we give you, again, highly discounted VMs, which you can use, but when someone else needs the capacity, we'll just shut them down, and you will get them when there is free capacity, right? So Spot VMs are really good also for certain scenarios, not for everyone. Don't use it for your important critical workloads, which need to run 24/7. But if you need to like go in and have some like calculation chops you need to do, then Spot VMs can be a great thing as well.
Yeah, so this is very interesting. I have not worked with this or seen this yet. It looks like this. Is this a preview type of thing, or has this been out for a while?
It's not a while. I'm not sure if it currently. It doesn't look like. I think we went GA with it, but okay. It like has been the last couple of weeks or maybe months. But it's not that old yet. I remember. I think I tweeted about it, but I can't remember when it was.
And so with these Spot VMs, I should think of these more along, or everybody should kind of like think of these more along the lines of, it's a pay-as-you-go type of thing, that wherever you decide that you want to stop, say you have a spend of like $200, it would run until you hit that threshold, and then it would just shut down. Is that kind of like the primary kind of like benefit?
Yeah, exactly. So you basically get it. But if someone else needs the resources, we just can take it away, right? And you get it again when we don't run that much anymore. so that's where you get. And then you have obviously a way better price for that. But again, your workload needs to support it. Otherwise, people are going to be very upset.
Gotcha.